Reflections, 40-day devotional, day 20. Blessings through tragedy. Sometimes what we think is our greatest tragedy is actually the means that God uses for us to receive our greatest blessing and to be a blessing to others. When Joseph's brothers became envious of him and the relationship that he had with their father, they sold him to the Ishmaelites, who in turn sold him to Potiphar, who was an officer of Pharaoh, the leader of Egypt. The thought never crossed their minds that there would come a day when they would be in desperate need of food for survival, and Joseph would be the one to provide it for them. Genesis chapters 37 through 39. Being separated from his family was very difficult for Joseph. He had to adapt to a new culture while at the same time maintain his relationship with God. He was lied upon, imprisoned unjustly, and forgotten by those whom he helped. He was experiencing the greatest tragedy of his life. Yet, in the midst of it all, he maintained his faith in God, knowing that whatever God allowed to take place in his life would work out for his good. How right he was. If Joseph had stayed in Canaan, he would not have gone through that tragic period in his life. And without that tragic period, he would not have had the exposure and the experience necessary to be the governor of Egypt. A position of great blessing, not just for him, but also for his family, the Egyptians, and all of the population in the surrounding area. In the midst of Joseph's tragedy, God was molding, shaping, and developing him, preparing him for a position of leadership that would benefit everyone. His years of slavery, tragic as they may have been, were for the survival, freedom, and salvation of all. Look for the blessing in the midst of your tragedy. You may be surprised at who will benefit.